The hand drill technique is harder to learn than the bow drill technique, simply because our hands, arms, and shoulders do all the work. Many people find it difficult to maintain control of the drill while applying the downward pressure. The problem is, the drill jumps out of the fireboard. When that happens, the heat is lost, and you have to start all over again. Sometimes it's hard to find a drill straight enough to use, but I have a solution for both of these problems: thumb loops and the hand drill socket. Many times it's difficult to find a drill straight enough to use. Maybe you can find just a short section that is straight enough. Well, what would you do with a small length like this for the hand drill technique? That's where the hand drill socket plays a part. Notice the socket is hollow in the center. I'm going to cut off this small piece of yucca and show you how the hand drill socket works. Well, here's the short piece of the yucca that we cut off. Remember, the hand drill socket is hollow. So on one end of the hand drill socket, we securely place the short piece of yucca. But still, the hand drill socket is not long enough. That's where this piece of hardwood dowel comes in. You say, but the dowel is straight, but it won't work because it's hardwood. But if we join the two together with the hand drill socket, now we have a usable hand drill spindle, thanks to the hand drill socket. We've got the short yucca plug connected to the long straight drill, connected there by the hand drill socket. The notch has been cut in the fireboard. We have our tender, our leather coal catcher, and also thumb loops, or the thumb loop socket. Let's see if we can get a fire now. Get everything in order. Here we go. You can get your hand drill socket at www.primalconnection.com. Be sure to tell Daryl the Southern Survivor sent you. See if we can blow it into a flame. The hand drill socket. When you order your hand drill socket from primalconnections.com, this is what you get: the hand drill socket itself, a good supply of mullen and basewood for the fireboard that already has been burned in. All you have to do is cut the notch.